Hello, thanks for hanging around with me for this video on step number two, demand forecasting. This is the process that we have talked about in the introduction video. And in video one, which was for step one, we talked about what to forecast, the span and the scope were the two words we used. And in this particular video, we are going to talk about getting appropriate data for forecasting. So there are two things which prevent us from getting accurate data. The number one thing is bullwhip effect, which happens across different firms in the supply chain. So consider this example. My consumption of toothpastes is relatively uniform. You know, if I brush two times a day, almost every day, so it's very uniform how much I consume. But my purchases from the supermarket or the grocery store are not uniform at all. Every time I finish an entire packet or a group of two or three packets, that's when I go out and buy two or three packets together. Similarly, while I would purchase two or three packets from the supermarket or the grocery store, the grocery store purchases toothpaste in probably a carton or a pallet load from a distributor. And a distributor would similarly order a few pallets together from the manufacturer or whoever they order from. So what we see is, even though my consumption of toothpaste is uniform, the distributor's purchase would be highly variable. And that's why the distributor's data of demand is actually highly unreliable. So whenever we are in a supply chain, bullwhip says that the demand fluctuates higher as we move upstream from the consumer to the manufacturer and supplier. And that's why the data that we have upstream is not a reliable data to forecast. Number two is this idea of silo effect, where we say different departments of the firm act as if they're different compartments and don't share enough data. So sometimes marketing departments create promotions, and the information about these promotions is not available to purchasing, manufacturing, and other promotions. Or there have been cases known where logistics department comes out with some kind of a new policy that they're only going to deliver once a week or in particular order. And that policy about delivery is not communicated adequately to the marketing, sales, and other departments. So to prevent these two main problems, there are many different methods, but we're going to talk of two specific methods. One is this method called CPFR, or Collaborative Planning, Forecasting, and Replenishment. Now, this bullwhip happens across firms in a supply chain. And since each firm is an independent entity, what we need to do here is we need to have a series of legal contracts or some pseudo-legal contracts about what each and every firm in the supply chain is going to do and how is it going to be involved or benefited because of this collaboration. So that's what CPFR is all about. It was designed by VICS, or Voluntary Inter-Industry Commerce Standards, and is useful specifically for the retail industry. But what we need to know here, or what I want to tell you here, is CPFR is about specific contracts for different members in a supply chain, about what specifically their role in demand forecasting and replenishment is. The second idea that I want to discuss is S&OP, or sales and operations planning. So again here, sales and operations planning looks at improving the forecasting or demand forecasting within the firm. So sales and forecasting is a specific process of how the final forecast number comes in the firm. So it starts with the demand function, creating an idea of the demand plan or what they think the market wants, which is then taken by the supply functions, the manufacturing and the sourcing, which say if they can manufacture enough, procure enough to meet their demand plan. And this then ultimately ends up in kind of a joint meeting where all the functions of the firm come together and arrive at one number at which they will work for the next month's or the next period's forecast. That's about it for this session, where what we saw was that there are two primarily across-firm problems and within-firm problems that prevent us from getting good data. And we had a brief glimpse into these two techniques, CPFR and S&OP, which helps us tackle this within-firm, across-firm and within-firm problems for sharing data and improving our forecasting process. Thank you. See you again across in the